Question 1, yeah. Figure 1, figure 11.1 shows a beam of radiation that contains alpha particle, this is alpha particle, beta particle, and gamma ray. The beam enters a very strong electric field between charged plate in vacuum. Beam radiation. Oh, we have, okay. Sebentar, Bapak izin ke depan dulu, Putri. Yeah, continue again, sorry. Indicate the deflection, if any, of alpha particle, beta particle, and gamma ray by placing one tick in each column of the table. Okay. No deflection is gamma ray. I think with what, yeah. Let's say VR. Yeah, this is thick, yeah. Why? Because gamma rays is electromagnetic wave, yeah, or light wave. There is no charge, yeah. If you know gamma ray is there is no charge, yeah. Kan gamma ray itu gamma yang begini, and this is zero, and this is zero, yeah. So there is no mass number or atomic number. So there's no deflection, yeah. There's no effect for negative or positive voltage. Okay, toward positive plate. Nah, go to positive plates when the particle is negative. Yeah, the particle negative is beta particle. This, yeah. Beta particle is electron. Yeah, beta. Yeah. Oh, okay. Beta. Kok nggak bisa ya? Beta is electron, ya, yeah, electron zero, ya, yeah, minus one, ya. Yeah. So they have minus one. Negative particle it will towards to positive plate, ya. Yeah. And toward to negative plate is alpha, ya, yeah, because alpha is positive charge, ya. Yeah. This. Then, out of the paper, out of the paper itu adalah gamma ray, ya. Karena gamma ray itu dia velocity-nya cepat, ya. Into the paper is alpha, karena dia berat. That's it. Bisa menembus kertas hanya berada pada di kertas, ya. Menembus kertas ini adalah gamma ray karena speed, high speed, ya. High speed, and kalau into the paper ini low speed and high mass, massanya berat. Jadi dia masih apa namanya di kertas, ya. Okay, ya. Continue to be question. The radiation is said to be ionizing. Explain what it means. Ionizing. This is about a chemical reaction, ya. Chemical reaction itu nanti larinya ke loss or gain electrons, ya. Jadi atom or molecules, ya. This is loss or gain electrons, ya. Atoms or molecules gain or loss electron. Jadi ionizing itu adalah atom or molecules dia gain or loss electrons, ya. Yeah, what I said before, what I mentioned, this is about chemical reaction, ya. Yeah. In the chemical reaction itu berarti kan ada kaitannya antara dapat elektron atau kehilangan elektron. And also, ya seperti itu ya, lebih cenderung elektron ya, kaitannya elektron, ya, elektron. Okay, continue. Alpha particles are more strongly ionizing, ya, and have a shorter range in air than gamma rays. Yeah. Use your knowledge of nature of this radiation to explain this difference. Pi, kemana? Itu kerudung itu katanya dua. Yes, back again. Alpha is helium nuclei. Yeah. Gamma rays is electromagnetic wave. Yeah. Sir, tuliskan kembali biar kalian ingat. Ini adalah helium nuclei. Yeah. And then gamma ray. Gamma ray is electromagnetic wave. Yeah. This is electromagnetic wave. Yeah. They don't have any charge. Yeah. In gamma rays. Yeah. Nah. So if we use our knowledge about the nature of this radiation to explain this difference, so let's say the first one, alpha particle has mass, but gamma ray is they don't have mass yet. Alpha particle have mass, yeah, but gamma don't have, yeah, tidak punya, yeah. Gamma is yeah, doesn't have mass, yeah. The first one is this, and the second one, this is about charge. Yeah, alpha have gamma doesn't have charge. Yeah, also. And alpha also, they have charge here. Yeah. I think that enough to two reason ya. Ini dua alasan kayaknya cukup ya. Bahkan ini empat alasan ya. Alpha, gamma, alpha, gamma. Okay, that's it. Okay, please take note. If you want to take note, I will back again around 3 minutes. Yeah, I will take drinking bottle first. Yeah, continue again, and we see other question. A technician sets up a radiation detector in university laboratory for use in some experiment. Even before the radioactive source for the experiment is broke into the laboratory, the detector registers a low count rate. Suggest what caused the count rate. Count rate is apa ya? This is about radiation, ya. And this broke laboratory detector. This is about radiation or they only detect. So let's say we can say this is background, yeah, background of radiation, yeah, bukan background of radiation, or kita sebut ini dalam kurung adalah radiation. Jadi kita bisa menentukan berapa besar radiasi itu dari background. Or trace, ya, jejak. Seperti hanya bayang-bayang saja tidak bisa kita tangkap secara, karena tidak bisa dihentikan. Karena radiasi itu sangat cepat sekali, hanya kita bisa lihat jejaknya aja, ya. Jejaknya itu kita katakan sebagai background aja, background of radiation. Nah, itu kita sebut sebagai count rate, ya, rata-rata perhitungan. Ya. Let's say gini, ya, misalkan kalian bermain dengan paint, dengan cat, ya, cat, kemudian kalian celupkan di dalam tangan, kemudian kayak cipratkan ke dalam tembok. Nah, itu semacam itu, cipratan ada di tembok itu adalah seperti kita menghitung konkretnya. Oh, itu cipratannya kok banyak sekali, ya, gitu. Seperti itu. Okay, a radioactive source that emits alpha particle is placed on the laboratory bench, and the source is gradually moved closer to the detector. Okay. At first, the detector continues to register a low count rate, sometimes slightly less than the count rate registered without the source. The count rate suddenly increases to very high value when the source is very close to the detector. Explain this change in count rate. Gini-gini. Sebutlah this is low count rate. Yeah. When on the due to background background radiation only, ya, yeah. Yeah. Low count rate due to background radiation only, yeah. And the second one we can this is, let's say, very high reading to alpha particle. Yeah. Very high reading due to alpha particle. Yeah. partikel. Yeah, I think this, yeah. Okay, see other question. This one, yeah. A second experiment, alpha particle pass between the parallel horizontal metal plates in vacuum. Yeah. They then continue detector as shown in figure 9.1. Yeah. Metal plate, detector source. A positive charge is established in upper plate. Yes, and negative charge on lower plate. Yeah. Sketch the new path alpha particle. State what happened to concrete registered by detector. This. Because this is positive, yeah, a negative charge. This is positive. Oh, sorry. Positive plate and the lower plate is negative. Oops. I will zoom in first. This is negative one. Yeah. And you know, we know, but alpha particle is positive, yeah. This is actually positive particle. So when positive particle move between positive and negative particle, so it will be deflect ataupun dia akan membelok ya ke arah negatifnya. So sketch a new path on the alpha particle. They will be seperti ini.
Pak.
Yes.
The worksheet that you gave us is not the one that you're doing right now.
Oh iya. Yeah. Astaga, kenapa enggak? No.
Apa beda itu?
No, not assignment on the material.
Material?
Yes.
Material kan yang ada di PDF-nya itu?
Yes.
Itu udah ada answer-nya, tapi beda juga.
Oh my god. Aduh. Sorry. Sebentar, search check dulu. Radioactivity 2.
Eh, never mind, Pak. Ada, Pak, yang material yang Bapak baru upload ya?
Iya.
Oke.
Sama kok ya, sama. Coba cek ini lagi ya. Itu mungkin yang sebelumnya, ya, assignment sebelumnya. Oke ya, continue again. Nah, this is C. In a question I, on figure 9.1, yeah, on figure 9.1, sketch new path on the alpha particle. Yeah. Oke. Okay. I repeat again about this. Yeah, alpha particle is positive charge, so they will be attracted to negative charge. But because alpha particle this is high velocity, jadi dia seperti ini ya, like apa namanya projectile motion, yeah, this gitu. This is a new path of alpha partikel. Kalau kita bikin, nah, petnya seperti itu, ya, trace-nya kurang lebih seperti itu. The new pet is. Okay, now state what happened to Conrad register by detector. Conrad it will be decreases. Kenapa? Detector ini kan hanya membaca ini secara umum ke bawah, tapi detector pasti membaca sebagian. Ya, maka ini Conrad it will be decreases, ya. Conrad decreases. Only background, background only ya, background only. Karena hanya jejaknya aja. Detector ini. Sama kayak kita hanya melihat bayangan, tapi tidak bisa menangkap bayangan. Conrad-nya akan decrease. Tapi background atau hanya background aja, hanya terlihat oh dia ke sana, oh dia ke sana, seperti itu. Ya. Oke, okay, I repeat again ya, if you don't still understand, because on this question they called me upper plate is positive charge ya, this is positive charge. And then the lower plate is negative charge, ya. Yeah. Yeah. Since alpha particle is positive charge, ya. Yeah. Positive charge, it will be attract with negative charge, and it will be repel with positive charge. Ya. Yeah. Jadi dengan yang di atas ini ditolak, dengan yang di bawah ditarik. Ya. Berarti dia kurvnya ini akan downward, ya. Yeah. Kurvnya akan downward, ya. Yeah. Saya ulang lagi ya. Nih, from the question, plate yang atas ini positif, ya, yeah, positif, 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 and then plate yang bawah negatif, 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 ya. Yeah. Nah, alpha particle ini ditembakkan dari source ini. Nah, alpha particle is positive charge. Now we using Coulomb's law that positive and positive itu repel. Positive and negative attract. So, dari atas ini dapat repel, dari bawah dapat attract. Jadi dia partikel alpha ini pasti turun ke bawah, downward curve gitu. Ya, yeah. Because also because this is speed very high, jadi dia geraknya ya seperti parabolik. Tidak bisa langsung plak jatuh ke bawah ya. Karena dia punya vektor velocity ke arah kanan, sehingga dia masih sempat ke kanan seperti itu. Ya. Oke, okay. I will continue again around 3 minutes later ya. Kalau mau digambar dulu silakan. Yeah, okay. Continue again, yeah, to other question. Oh, number three. 3A. A technician sets up a radiation detector in a university laboratory used in a class experiment. Yeah. A radioactive source that emits beta particles, yeah, is placed on the laboratory bench 10 cm from the detector. Small contact is registered. Yeah. State the name of the particle found in an atom that is identical to a beta particle. Oh. The beta particle is electron, yeah. Yes, electron. I repeat again, yeah, about alpha, beta, and gamma. Alpha is helium nuclei. Beta is electron. And gamma is electromagnetic wave. Alpha, beta, and gamma. Yeah. This is produced by fusion reaction. Yeah. Ketika ada inti atom mengalami pecah, yeah, nuclear atom, they produce some radioactive ray. The radioactive ray is alpha, beta, and gamma. Alpha is helium nuclei, beta is electron, and gamma is electromagnetic wave. Yeah. Okay, now the technician set up the same equipment the same fair way every year. He noticed that the contact registered by the detector every year is slightly smaller than it was previous year. Yeah, suggest why this is so. This is about decay, yeah. Jadi half life, ya, yeah, meluruh dia. Bisa juga ini, ya, yeah, aktivitas pengurangan, ya, yeah, or decay, ya. Yeah. Activity decay. Jadi radioaktif itu kan berkurang, ya. Meluruh apa? Meluruh itu apa namanya? Decay gitu. Ya. And this is about also apa namanya? Half life, ya. Sebutlah half life. Half life. Wait. Ordinary, sorry. Decay of something inappropriate. Yeah. Decay something something decay in appropriate decay of something inappropriate, yeah. Dan ini tadi ya half life, ya, yeah. Half life, mention yang kita apa namanya mention sensitivity. Mention about sensitivitas atau sensibel ya. Yeah. Sebenarnya ya sama kayak gini ya, unsur radioaktif itu akan selalu habis, bukan habis, berkurang ya, berkurang. Berkurang setengahnya, berkurang setengahnya, berkurang setengahnya ya, ya. Itu yang kita sebut sebagai activity decay ya. Aktivitas peluruhan namanya ya. Because nuclear atom they have decay ya for several times. And every a half decay is about half life. Yeah. So I put this decay of something inappropriate half life mention sensibly. Seperti itu. Apalagi nih. Coba kita lihat yang II. In a second experiment, the same equipment is set up, but a radioactive source that emits alpha particles is placed 10 cm from the detector. The same number of particles are emitted every second from this source as were emitted from beta source in. Explain the content obtained is much lower. Source that emit alpha particle. Explain why Conrad obtained. Wait. Sebentar ya, kalau kita lihat yang atas. Apa ya? Oh, I know. This is alpha depends by beta. Oh, we know alpha they have mass more than beta, yeah. So this is about mass. About mass, yeah. Okay. Kok nggak bisa. Sorry. Alpha ya, alpha particle ya, more ionizing than beta ya. Than beta particle the first one ya, and the second one ya. Alpha hermos have more mass ya. Yeah. Alpha also have more mass. Bisa mass, bisa charge. Mass charge also dia lebih besar ya, size also ya. And then kemudian dia pasti collision-nya lebih besar, tabrakan ya, collision ya, then beta particle. Yes, that's it.
Pak, maksudnya decay of something inappropriate half-life mentioned sensibility itu apa?
Itu adalah peluruhan dari sesuatu ya yang kemudian dilihat dari sensitivitas itunya, half-life-nya. Kita membaca sesuatunya itu radioaktif, unsur radioaktif yang kemudian kita baca half-life-nya, ya, half-life-nya. Ini kalau kita baca the technician set up equipment sama he noticed the contact respirator. Every year is likely smaller than it was previous year. Ya, suggest. Ya, yang pertama sebenarnya aktivitas decay. Ya, nah yang kemudian decay dari apa dia? Ya, decay dari something appropriate half-life. Ya, kemudian kita nggak tahu apa di sana. Ya, hanya dia nge-set up equipment. Ya, radioaktif.
Nah, something inappropriate apa?
Apa ya, sesuatu unsur yang tidak kita tahu di sana ada apa gitu. Coba kalau ser lihat ini ya sebentar. Jadi gini, this is about nuclei, ya, atom, dan itu tidak bisa kita lihat secara kasat mata, ya. Tapi kita bisa membayangkan, ya, atau mengira-ira, ya, mengkira-kira di sana terjadi peluruhan, ya, terjadi decay. Nah, decay dari unsur radioaktif itu yang kemudian kita sebut sebagai something inappropriate gitulah, sesuatu yang nggak mengerti gitulah, ya, sesuatu mengerti yang kemudian dibaca oleh apa namanya, oleh dibaca oleh kita sebagai waktu paru itu. Oke. Okay. Atau nanti saya jelaskan lagi aja deh ya. Kayaknya ini sudah jam 10.59. One more minute. Nanti tentang ini nanti mungkin Bapak akan jelaskan ulang. Yeah. Oke, okay. I need you all to open the video. I will take the picture first ya, yeah, for